Welcome to Differential Equation Tutorial with Brother Maxwell Benemoris. This is my second video on differential equations. Today we'll be looking at homogeneous equations. But the equation given to us will not be homogeneous. We have to reduce the equation to homogeneous equation. Equations in this form here is not homogeneous because of the two constants, because of C1 and C2. Nevertheless, we can still reduce this equation to homogeneous differential equation and solve. So in the case here, before reducing this equation to homogeneous differential equation, we need to take into consideration two cases. So there are two cases that involve in reducing equations to homogeneous differential equations. Let's look at case one. For case one, case 1 tells that if the ratio of A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2, then we should set small x to be equal to capital X plus H and differentiate. We get D of X equal to D of capital X, differentiate constant equal to 0. And we set small y to be equal to capital Y plus K and differentiate. We have D of small y equal to D of capital Y, and on differential constant equal to 0. Then we do variable separable. We will have D of small y over D of small x equal to D of capital Y over D of capital X. So after this one, we can replace D of small y over D of small x by this entire equation here. And thereafter, we place small y and small x into the equation and solve for the constants. After solving the equation for the constant, we can do our variable. Hereafter, we integrate and we can solve the differential equations. This occurs for case one. For case two, tells that if the ratio of A1 over A2 equal to B1 over B2. If the two ratios are equal, then what we'll do? We can set Z to be equal to A1X plus B1Y. We can make Y the subject in this particular equation here and differentiate. Thereafter, we can easily solve the Y in differential equations. So, let's look at examples where we'll use both case 1 and case 2. Let's get started. Now, so let's look at the example board here. This is our differential equation. But this differential equation is not homogeneous because of the constant minus 3 up and minus 3 in the denominator. Nevertheless, as I told you, we can still reduce this equation to homogeneous equations. So the first and foremost thing, let's see which one of the cases that will be used here. So here, let's look here. Let's look at the ratio of A1 over A2. So A1 here is the coefficient of X is 1, A2 here is 2. And let's see the ratio of B1 over B2. So here we have 2 over 1. We can see that A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2. We can see this, it's very clear. A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2. So now, it means that case 1 is applicable to these differential equations. So we use case 1 to solve. So let's move here. So first thing, since A1 over A2 not equal to B1 over B2, what we will do here is that we will set let X equal to capital X plus H. When we reach this far, we have to differentiate. So we'll differentiate here, we have D of small x will be equal to D of capital X. After this, we move to the next one. We say let Y be equal to capital Y plus K. When we reach at the point, we differentiate again, we have D of small y equal to D of capital Y. So at this point yet, we can divide D of small y by D of small x, and we divide D of capital Y by D of capital X. So when we do this, we will have D of capital Y over D of capital X, which will be equal to D or small Y over D or small X. So at this point yet, we can see that D of small y over D of small x is equal to this entire differential equation here. So dual replacement. So here we have D of capital Y over D of capital X will be equal to, here we have x plus 2y minus 3 or over 2x plus y minus 3 at this point. So thereafter, what we can do next, we have to rewrite this differential equation in terms of capital X and capital Y. So here we have D of capital Y over D of capital X will be equal to, in this particular case now, we come to do our substitution. What was it? Small s, we replace small s by capital S plus H. What we see Y, we replace Y by capital Y plus K. So dual substitution here, S is what? Capital X plus H plus 2Y is what? Capital Y plus 2K minus 3. Or we'll come here, 2 capital X plus 2 small H plus capital Y plus K minus 3. So we'll do this, we're going to separate our constants. So here we have D of capital Y over D of capital X will be equal to, we have capital X plus 2Y constant on one side plus H plus 2K minus 3 or over 2 capital X plus capital Y plus 2 small H plus K minus 3. So now, at this point, we can see our constant have been separated. So here we can take the constant down and see how we can solve. So we'll come here now, we take the constant, we have H plus 2K minus 3 equal to 0. Then we have 2H plus K minus 3 also equal to 0. So here we can see how we can solve for both H and K. Using elimination method to solve for H and K, we will have H to be equal to 1 and K also equal to 1. We'll have to solve for H and K and do by itself. So yeah, after solving for H and K, we can rewrite our differential equation now. We have D of capital Y over D of capital X equal to capital X plus 2 capital Y over 2 capital X plus Y. So at this point now, we can set on capital Y to equal to small V capital X. So we can do our substitution there. But before the substitution, we have to differentiate first. So we'll differentiate, we get D of capital Y over D of capital X equal to, we can hold V constant, we differentiate X, we get V, when you differentiate X, you get 1. So plus, we can hold S constant, differentiate V, we get dV over dX. So when we reach at this point, we can do our replacement. What we see, the capital Y of D or capital X, replace it by X plus 2Y over 2X plus Y. So here we have capital X plus 2Y over 2 capital X plus Y equal to V plus X dV over dX. So here we can replace capital X and capital Y but using Y is equal to V times X. So let us replace Y. So whole X constant here, X plus 2, Y now here is VX So we get V capital X all over. So we have 2x plus the value for y now is Vx. So here you can easily see that. So you can easily see that yet we have s is common and s in the denominator also common. So here we have d of capital y over d of capital x. So x here and x here will cancel with common. So here we're left with 1 plus 2v all over 2 plus v equal to d of capital y over d of capital x at this point. So when we reach this far, what we need to do now is to, what we shouldn't forget that we have v plus x dv over the x here. So let us include there now. So let's do our so here we have v plus x dv over dx. Sorry, instead of dy over dx. So we have this. So here we have dv, we have x plus v. Alright. So now when we reach this final, we can send v across. So sending v across, we have 1 plus 2v all over 2 plus v. If v comes across, it changes to minus v equal to, we have x dv now over dx. So here we can do our common modifications. So here we have 1 plus 2v minus, multiply again, minus 2v minus v squared. So all over, we have 2 plus v, which will be equal to x dv all over dx. So here we can see that, we can clearly see that positive 2v will cancel negative 2v. So we left with 1 minus v squared all over 2 plus v equal to x dv all over dx. So at this point, we can do our variable separable. So doing the variable separable, we have 1, let's rewrite our equation here. So we have 1 minus v squared all over 2 plus v equal to x dv all over dx. So separating the variable here, we will yield to 2 plus v all over 1 minus v squared dv will be equal to dx all over x. So here we can take our integral both sides. Taking the integral both sides here, so since the variable I've been separated, we can now take our integral both sides. So the integral I've already taken both sides, we can now integrate. So integrating it, we can split this two. Integral, we have 1 plus 1 plus v all over 1 minus v squared dv, which will be equal to the integral of dx all over x. So here, at this point, we can also divide this. So here we have the integral of, we have 1 all over 1 minus v squared dv plus, we have 1 plus v, which will be integral all over 1 minus v squared dv, which will be equal to an integral of dx all over x. So when we reach at this point here, we use our special integral function. Don't forget. So the special integral function, the integral of 1 all over
a square minus x square dx.
The expression of our function
is equal to 1 all over 2a ln of a plus x all over a minus x. So we use this special integral function to solve this particular problem. So using this special integral function, it will yield to 1 all over 2 ln of, we have 1 plus x. So say this v, and now we don't want to use x, we use v. So 1 plus v all over 1 minus v plus, now when we integrate this, we know we can further write this, we'll get 1 plus u, 1 minus u. So 1 plus u, we can have 1 plus u, only 1 minus u will be there. So 1 all over 1 minus u integrated, this time will change from what? From positive to negative. So here we'll change to minus, we'll get minus ln of 1 minus v. Sorry, v, I mean, it's 1 minus v. So we equal to, we'll integrate this, we'll get ln of x. So here, our sum constant ln of c. So now, after the integration here, we can see that we have make life extremely easier for ourselves. So the next thing we do is that we can derivative 2 here, multiply 2 both sides. So multiply the 2 here, we use the fraction, we turn both sides by 2. So here we have the ln of 1 plus v all over 1 minus v. Minus will get 2 ln of, we have 1 minus v equal to, we have 2 ln of x plus ln of c. Good. So now, the next thing we can do here is that we can replace our v value. We know that capital Y is equal to V of small x. So I mean V of capital X. So here replacing V value, V will be equal to capital Y over capital X. So now we'll see V replace V by capital Y over capital X. So doing this, we'll have the ln of, we have 1 plus capital Y over capital X all divided by, so we have 1 minus capital Y over capital X minus here, we have 2, do the same thing here, 2, the ln of, so we come here, 1 minus capital Y over capital X, we close it, which will be equal to, we can extend the side here, 2, I will then say we have ln of x plus ln of c, inclusive. So here, we can solve this. If we solve this, or x times 1, we get x plus y, or x. X times 1, we get x minus y over x. This is a complex fraction. We have to solve this. It will yield to ln of, we have x plus y all over x minus y. Yeah. And here we'll solve this. Now we have minus 2 ln of, we have x minus y all over x. You close it. So here will be equal to, so here we have multiply, we have 2 ln of x plus 2 ln of c. So here, let's say we come on the side and continue our solving. So now, what we have, ln of x plus y all over x minus y minus, so we have 2 ln of, so we have x minus y all over x equal to 2 ln of x plus 2 ln of c. So we can still simplify this expression further by using the property of logarithms. So here we can see that here we have 2 ln of x minus y over x. It can be split in this form as we have ln of x plus y over x minus y minus 2 ln of x minus y. Same here now is what? It's division, we will subtract. But so it's negative sign, we'll have negative sign, we'll change the y. Positive 2 ln of x, which will be equal to 2 ln of x plus 2 ln of c. We can see here now that 2 ln of x will cancel 2 ln of x. So here, we left with ln of x plus y over x minus y, which will be, let's say minus, yeah, minus 2 ln of x minus y, which will be equal to 2 ln of c. Good. Now, at this point, we can still simplify this further again. So, simplifying this will yield to, let's look here. Same here now, this is what the coefficient of everything. It can also serve as the exponent of this. So, we can rewrite this as, let's look here. Let me bring it up here so you will see clearly. We have ln of, we have x plus y over x minus y. So here we have minus, we have ln of, here we have x minus y closing square will be equal to 2 ln of c. So here now we can see that this is a natural law we are dealing with. So in the case here, we can also apply the property of logarithm in holes here. So since this is negative here, we can divide. Dividing this by this, it means that the exponent for this will also be corresponding to the exponent of this. Here is 2 and here is 1. So here, this 2 plus this 1 here, we will add the exponent, we will apply it, we will have 3. So here we have ln of x plus y over x minus y close it or cube. So here it will be equal to 2 ln of c. So we can easily see here that plate for this 2 will serve at the exponent of c squared. So here we will have c squared, ln of c squared. But we can just set k to be equal to ln of c squared or c squared itself to make like it was, that's a constant. So here, taking the antilog of both sides, ln of cancel ln. So here we have x plus y all over, you have x minus y equals to all cube. Now be equal to, we can say c or we can say k, for it's a constant. So here, when we reach at this point now, we can try to replace the value of capital X and the value of capital Y. So we do the replacement here now. Let's do our replacement first up. So we know that small x was equal to capital X plus H. So it means capital X will be equal to small x minus h, and h here is 1. So capital X will be equal to small x minus 1. And what is that? Capital Y will be equal to small y minus 1. So we do our replacement here now. So capital X, I'm thinking about small x minus 1 of y minus y plus we have small y minus 1, all divided by, we'll do the same thing here again. We have small s minus 1. So here we have positive, negative, negative here, minus. Then we have further one here. We have small y minus 1. We close it. So yes, r cube equal to k. So here we can do this. Now we have x plus small y minus 2 all over. Simplify in here. So negative and negative are positive. So you get x minus y. This and this will cancel out. But this positive, so this will cancel out. So here we have x minus y equals a r cube, which will be equal to k. So this is our final answer. So thank you for your time. You can book me on my next video where we will be using the first principle. Or we'll be using case 2. Because today we use case 1 where we finalized that the ratio of A1 or A2 was not equal to B1 or B2. In the next video, you will finalize that A1 over A2 will be equal. And we'll see what the method we use to reduce the equation to homogeneous equation for solving. Thank you for your time.